Good afternoon. This is Silver Spring Exploration Command Center calling in. The dive on USS Bugara. We are joined today by Ed Edner, who was the commanding officer of Bugara 1957 and 1958.
It's very interesting to see your home in a different perspective, but the clarity and a certain attachment to it when you see something like this, you realize it's resting peacefully on the bottom. A lot of memories inside that boat.
Okay, what you're looking at is the exhaust, and now we're at the top of the snorkel. Ed Edner was telling us that he had to write one of the first manuals for how to use these and installing them in our fleet boats. And he said he wrote that in 47.
Yeah.
So down below this band of superstructure is the actual pressure hull of the submarine. On top of that, that superstructure was once covered not only by the steel that you see here, but also by a teak deck. That teak deck is now gone. I believe it's been consumed by marine organism. What we're seeing right now is you see a little bit of curved track that's coming up off to the left-hand side of the image. That's safety track, the safety rail. And the guys could actually cable into that when they were operating on the boat deck in heavy seas so that they wouldn't be washed off.
One of the notable achievements is that she came across a Chinese junk that was forced to operate for the Japanese, and it was being attacked by pirates, and two of the Chinese crew had already been killed. And Vera came in there and rescued the Chinese crew and destroyed the pirates.
And then sank the boat because it was operating for the Japanese, but saved the crew.
And so, I think that was the case in most of the attacks on junk. They were able to take the crew off and some of their supplies and some of their personal effects, and then sink the junk and then put the crews ashore.
So as we approach the stern of Bugara, as you can see the aft torpedo tubes, these boats had the capacity to fire both from the bow and the stern. You can see the dive planes coming into view with Bugara's rudder, and also down to the bottom you can see the propellers coming into view as well now.
Propellers are actually around 8 feet in length, each propeller, so the diameter is around 16 feet.
Josh, this is really good. Getting a nice view now of the stern chock right here. We're at the very tail end of the superstructure.
So there's a nice view of a very large lingcod there.
Absolutely, and as that lingcod moves along, he perfectly outlines the aft hatch, gate trunk.
The fish that you see there are mostly redfin and rockfish, and there's some lingcod, that's the grayer one. And then all of those beautiful white plumed anemones, those are Matrudiums.
Visit to Bugara has answered a few questions for us. We don't see any evidence of a sudden event that tanker, but rather looks like a progressive slow flooding. Where that came from, hard to say, but it looks like she just slowly filled, and at the final point when they realized she was going, they had to cut the lines, and she came down, as you can see, pretty much level onto the bottom. What we're certainly seeing here as well is some sinking damage, implosion. She got to a certain depth of some of the main airlines, which, as you can see, not only have collapsed the actual manifold piping itself, form some of the deck stringers and a little bit of the superstructure around it. A couple of possibilities are that water came in through the snorkel if there was any kind of wave action.
Mm-hmm.
If the top of the snorkel didn't seat, another possibility would be some failure, something was kept open that slowly began to progressively flood her. Or it could be that the stern glands, the propellers, may have introduced the peak. Ed's sense was that it probably came from around the sail. We have achieved every goal we had looked for, a couple minor things, but we are content and we are ready to bless and release you for recovery of vehicle.